God and one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake God forgives us all of our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sin. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's join in our opening song this morning. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, how can we begin to repay the great deed of love that your Son has done for us and for all the world, that in his death on the cross, in being lifted up, He would be redeemed. He would redeem all humanity. O Lord, let the light of Jesus' love shine brightly in our hearts today and all the days of our lives. For we pray this in your Son Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
The first reading is from the book of Genesis, chapter 12. Now the Lord said to Abram, "Go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you, and make your name great so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and the ones who curse you I will curse. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed." So Abram went as the Lord had told him, and Lot went with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in a responsive prayer of Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come?
My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber.
He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep.
The Lord is your keeper.
The Lord is your shade at your right hand.
The sun shall not strike you by day,
nor the moon by night.
The Lord will keep you from all evil.
He will keep your life.
The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in,
from this time on and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
The second reading is from the book of Romans, chapter 4. What then are we to say was gained by Abraham, our ancestor according to the flesh? For if Abraham was justified by works, he has something to boast about, but not before God. For what does the scripture say? Abraham believed God, and it was reckoned to him as righteousness. Now to one who works, wages are not reckoned as a gift, but as something due. But to one who without works trusts him who justifies the ungodly, such faith is reckoned as righteousness. For the promise that he would inherit the world did not come to Abraham or to his descendants through the law, but through the righteousness of faith. If it is the adherents of the law who are to be the heirs, faith is null and the promise is void. For the law brings wrath, but where there is no law, neither is there violation. For this reason, it depends on faith in order that the promise may rest on grace and be guaranteed to all his descendants, not only to the adherents of the law, but also to those who share the faith of Abraham. For he is the father of us, of all of us, as it is written, "I have made you the father of many nations," in the presence of the God in whom he believed, who gives life to the dead and calls into existence the things that do not exist. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the third chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God." Jesus answered him, "Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh. What is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, 'You must be born from above.' The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes to. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly, I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So I invite all the kids to come forward this morning for the children's sermon, and you definitely want to come up for that. I just see Ms. Tina Gray here this morning. Hello, Tina. It's nice to see you today. Right. Her brother Matt's on the other side of the sanctuary, I think. Or maybe he's at the back there. Maybe he's at the booth. All right. Good morning, guys. So today, we're going to see a video about camp in a little bit, probably towards the end of the sermon. But we're going to talk a little bit about camp. And I want to show you something that you'll definitely need whenever it is that you end up going to camp, okay? You'll need to take a water bottle, all right? Now, one of the things I like to do with my water bottles is put stickers on them, okay? Maybe you don't have a water bottle at home, but I want you to have one of these stickers. In fact, in a moment, not right now, but in a moment, I'm going to have you take one for yourself and two to give away to other people, okay? So you'll take three stickers in a moment, one for yourself and two for other people, okay? Everybody understand? And the reason we want to choose these stickers is, right, because they are a good reminder to us, right? They remind us of God's promise. These are all stickers that remind us of God's promise, okay? So you want to put it in a place where you can see it, all right? Well, you'll see it every day. Maybe you want to put it, you'd have to ask for permission to do this, I suppose, if you want to put it like on the headboard of your bed, right? But you'll need to put it on something hard, okay? Like plastic or wood, or maybe on your laptop if you've got a computer, or maybe on the back of your phone if you have a phone already. I don't know, right? But you don't want to put it on fabric, okay? Because it won't stick to fabric. So you don't want to put it on your shirt. It probably won't work on your backpack unless your backpack has a nice hard piece of plastic or something, okay? You want to put it on something hard. Now, these stickers, right, they tell us about God's love. They remind us, and they show other people a little bit, right? So maybe someone would see my sticker. It says, let go and let God, right? That's a reminder to me not to worry, to let go of my worries and let God take care of my worries, all right? Now, I want to tell you about the kinds of stickers there are. How many do you get to choose, right? Three, one for yourself and two to give away, okay? I see you moving in closer and closer there, Xander. Right? All right. He had a smile on his face. So these are all different stickers. They all tell us about God, okay? The stickers on this side here have to do with flowers, okay? They all have a Bible verse on them, okay? So here's flowers. Okay, everybody take a step back. Take one step back. Okay, very good. All right, we'll take turns, right? Everybody will get to choose. There's lots here, okay? These stickers in the middle, okay, they have fewer words in them, okay? They all have really neat shapes, okay? These stickers over here have Bible verses on them. So if you like to memorize Bible verses, maybe you want to choose some from right in here. Here's some more stickers that have like single words on them, like this one says Jesus, right? This one says be the good, so on and so forth. This one says Bible. And these stickers over here are shapes, okay? These stickers are hearts and circles and crosses, all right? And they all have different Bible passages, okay? So please take three stickers, okay? Go ahead and choose. All right, there's lots to choose from, so take your time choosing. Go ahead, Xander. Go ahead and pick some out, okay? There's hearts, there's crosses, okay? Maybe you want to step back a little bit, and remember, there's flowers on this side, and there's words on this side. Maybe take a step back so everybody can see, and that way you can look over everything. And once you've chosen your three stickers, then come on back here, and we'll say a prayer. By the way, these stickers, do you know where they come from? They come from Miss Nancy. So, right here, look at me. So, we want to say thank you to Miss Eisenbrand, okay? Teachers have really good stuff, don't they? Right? Yeah, they sure do. Okay, so choose your three stickers and then come stand back here by the baptismal font, okay? Once you've got your three chosen, one, two, three, right? Simon. Xander, do you have three? You got two. You do have three. Very good. Very good. All right. Already learning our numbers. That's the way to go. Okay? All right. So remember, when you go to Bible camp, right? And well, maybe, Xander, you might have to wait a couple of years before you go to Bible camp. But camp is, I think you become eligible for camp depending on what kind of camp, whether it's, you know, even family camp, kids of all ages can come. But I think they have their first overnights, probably about second grade, is that right? Second grade, I know that's when our daughter went. So if you're not yet second grade, don't worry. You can sign up for camp with your mom or dad for family camp, or even just to go out for a day and have a picnic up at Okoboji, because it's a really neat place. It's up at the lakes, all right? So would you fold your hands, please? And I'm going to say a prayer, okay? So please fold your hands. Dear God, thank you for the fun of camp. Thank you for all of these children. Watch over them, God. We thank you, O Lord, for these fun things like stickers that remind us of your love and remind us of everything that Jesus has done. Bless these kids, Lord, as they go home today and as they go back to school tomorrow. For we pray in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. All right, you can be seated. Thank you. And while the kids are being seated, I'll invite Mr. Quanbeck forward. Rod Quanbeck has been camp director at Ingham Okoboji for about 15 years. We have a common cohort in crime. One of my mentors is Pastor Ron Letness. So that's someone that Rod got to know pretty well. So well, I'm going to step to the side and let Mr. Quanbeck tell you about all the fun of camp. So welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Chris. And good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So great to be with you this morning. What a privilege it is to come and worship with you and spend the morning with you. I've been blessed already and look forward to greeting and meeting even more of you after the service. So thank you for being here. Thank you for the ministry you are doing. What a blessing it is to be in this place, this beautiful sanctuary. Beautiful stained glass that tells the story of our Lord and Savior and the church. And this tremendous expanse that reminds us of the awe of our amazing God. And these great acoustics in which, you know, in which instruments and voices just carry. It's really awesome to be with you. Thank you. I feel welcome and had a great time with Sunday school kids, middle of between the two services as well. My friend and co-worker, Tim Matz, is with me. Tim, would you just stand up quick? Tim is our director of maintenance at camp, and we're so grateful for him. He has some roots in this area as well. His grandpa Miller lived in this community, and this was his church, his grandparents' church as well. And so Tim said, hey, I'd love to come with you this morning. And he's been greeting some of you and helping me tell the story of camp. So great to have Tim with me. My name's Rod. I've been to camp at Ingham Okoboji for 15 years now. Spent 19 years at a different camp way up in North Dakota, 20 miles from the Canadian border before coming down here. And some people think it's colder up there. And it is. And winter is a month longer as well. And I don't miss the long winter, actually. But I'm really delighted to be here and be part of Ingham Okoboji Lutheran Bible Camps. Before I go any further, I want to tell you why I carry a canoe paddle. And the reason is that everywhere I go, it's my great privilege to tell people about the ministry of Ingham Okoboji Lutheran Bible Camp. And there are two things I like to share. One, we have fun. In fact, I have a t-shirt that I once made and I want to repeat it again that says on the back, warning, campers have fun while growing in Christ. And the second thing I always like to share is our mission statement, to know Jesus Christ and to make Christ known to all. Pretty basic, pretty simple, pretty key, though, in life. And so I'm here this morning to share those things as well. But I want to also share some other things about camp. But please hear this more than anything else. Thank you for your partnership. It is a tremendous privilege to be partners with you in the ministry of the gospel. Thank you for your involvement in the Ingham Okoboji Bible Camp ministry. Thank you for your prayers, for your financial support. Thank you for coming to camp. Thank you for encouraging your youth to come to camp. Thank you for providing summer staff and now a year-round staff member to be part of our team, and Pastor Renee as our Ingham Lake director. And many staff members who have been tremendous have come from this community and this congregation. So thank you for raising them up and preparing them to be great camp counselors and other camp staff. And it's certainly, thank you for the quilts that you make and for coming to camp as youth, as families some, and to our elderversity and other year-round retreats. It's a great privilege to be involved with you, to have you as partners, and more than anything else, as partners in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Before I go any further, would you just pray with me? Lord, thank you that you are always faithful. Thank you for your love for us and for the world. Thank you for the privilege it is to know you and serve you. And pray, Lord, that you'd guide these few moments that we share together this morning and guide our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, you know, I want to share this morning something, honestly, I've never shared before at a congregation. But it's kind of, it's basic. It's really important to the ministry of the camp. And I want to share with you our primary objectives. I know most of you want to jump up and down and cheer. Because like some other places, that's not as exciting as it is at camp, though. So you can stand up and cheer anytime you want this morning. That's fine. But I want to share, you know, our primary objectives start with our mission statement, which we've already shared, to know Jesus Christ and to make Christ known to all. And in it, above all else, we want everyone that comes to camp to know something more about Jesus. In fact, to know Jesus, to know that Jesus came for them, that God loves them and sent his son Jesus into the world, and that there is life in Jesus. And we want people to know Christ and have faith in Christ and live in a relationship with Christ and God, Almighty God, the Triune God. And I'd like to share a verse that's very familiar to lots of people, but John 15. If you look at the book of John 15 in a red letter Bible, it's pretty much all red. Jesus is talking the whole way through, and almost, maybe one little glimpse here and there that's not. But one of the things he says early on, he's talking about being the vine, and we're the branches. In fact, he says, I am the vine, you are the branches. And he says, if you abide in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. That's really a core message at camp. It wasn't very many weeks ago, I was at another church sharing about camp, and after the first service, I was at a table in the back and talking about camp, trying to tell people that didn't know a lot about camp. They had, it's a church that had sent a lot of kids to camp over the last decade. Most of them are coming from families for whom English is not their first language. And some of that was clear. And I thought, this is such a great opportunity to share about camp. And so I was standing behind the table, and people were coming by, mostly moms, and some, they were kind of picking up a brochure here and there, talking to each other, some in English, some not. And this one gal kind of paused, and she was looking longer, and it seemed like, oh, this is someone I really want to tell about camp, because maybe she'll encourage her kids to come to camp. And I really believe that that's helpful for kids, so I'm happy to share that. And so I pointed out this my favorite piece of paper on the table. I said, I just love this. It's actually our fall newsletter, but there's two full pages of quotes from kids who've been to camp and how camp blessed them. And this mom, she said, I don't need to read that, because my David was one of those kids that came to camp, and his life was changed. And she told me he came home, and he wanted to read his Bible more, and his heart, his attitude changed toward his parents. He wanted to go to church, which he hadn't really wanted to do before. There were some big things that changed in his life. And you know what it was? He was abiding in the vine. He had found he belonged to Jesus and was living there and finding his life in a living relationship with Christ. And it was so fun to hear David's mom tell me that. I don't know her name, but God does, and she's rejoicing that her son is growing in a faith relationship with Jesus. So that's number one. We want to share about Jesus. Our second objective is we want to cultivate a love for the Word of God. And you know, in this book, there is life. It is truth. And it's all inspired by our God. And it's powerful and lots of things. Sharper than two-edged sword. You know, all kinds of great things. Some of them hard. Some of them joyous. But it's all joyous because it's God's Word for us. And we want to share that with our campers and help them experience the joy of digging into the Bible. And so we learn lots of Bible verses. Usually we put them to a song. There's some actions, and that's a great way to help remember the Word. And we also have this time that's called Vine Time. And it's just set aside for them to read their Bible and pray and have some time that they know is just with God, abiding in the vine. And that's so important. You know, even the sacraments are so very important to us, but they find their power because they're connected with the Word. The primary means of grace is the Word of God. Secondary are the sacraments. Good stuff. Great place for all of us to learn. We have life, and we get to learn about God's great love for us. Thirdly, I want to share about our desire to invite people to recognize they are created for relationship with God and each other, and that because God is our creator, God knows about how best we can relate with the Lord and with each other. And so God's word we learn about God's design and the life that we have that he has for us. That's the best life there could be, a life of letting God flow through us in all of our relationships and be guided in all of our relationships. And that includes family, it includes friendships and relationships with our neighbors, the authorities. You know, sometimes we don't always rejoice in what God says about those, but it's good word for us to hear, isn't it? And even our enemies. God has good word for us to learn how to live the best life there is, and it's with him guiding us. Fourthly, we want to equip, encourage, and train Christian leaders. And the way that happens the most at camp is through our summer staff. And it's a great privilege to have staff come year after year, come and spend the summer with us, and say, here am I, send me. I'm answering the call. I'm going to be there for the summer to share the great news of Jesus with others. And while they're there, not only do they help others grow in Christ, but they grow and they become leaders. 2 weeks of great staff training and then practicing all summer long, sharing and leading and helping others get into the Word, share God's love with each other, resolve conflicts. You know, all those things that are part of life, they're part of a cabin group at camp too. And it's a great way to be a leader. And thank you again for being a church and a community that has provided lots of great staff. And in fact, I want to invite you to do that again. We need some more. We need about 70, between 70 and 75 staff this summer. We're not quite halfway there. So would you, even every one of you, think just for 5 seconds right now, who do I know that I could encourage to be a camp staff member? High school junior or senior or older? And they could come and serve and grow. And you know, as they're at camp, they are serving, but they really are learning life skills. We hear again and again from people who have been camp counselors that in all kinds of other places in life, future careers. They say, you know, I learned this at camp. Some of the stuff that I learned by being a staff member was more useful than lots of things I even learned in college, because it was good life skills and people skills. And also, your pastor, did you know you probably do? Your pastor sensed his call from the Lord to be a pastor while he was on a summer camp staff. And that happens again and again and as well. So help us identify future leaders that may spend a summer on a camp staff and then end up maybe being your next pastor or someone else's. Please help us with that. It's such a joy to see that happen and to see that growth happen. Also, Haley Bogue is from your congregation. What a delight she is as part of our staff. And we're so grateful for her and for Pastor Renee, who so often refers to your church as one that was so instrumental in her years as well. And she's our director at Ingham Lake Camp. So we want to continue to raise up and help train Christian leaders, and that's happening at camp. Another objective of ours is to help people know that God's heart is for the world. We want to be part of God's global vision. You know, just this morning, one of the key verses in the passage of the gospel that you likely have heard before, maybe you've sung songs, and many people know John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son. You know, it's the world. It's not just you and me and our favorite people, the whole world. Even the people that are the other, political party. Everyone, God gave his life, his son, for everyone, that they would be able to believe and have life in Jesus that's eternal. And we want to share God's heart for the world. One of the ways we do that at camp is every summer we seek to have international staff as part of our summer staff. We've got one coming for sure this summer and a couple others that are talking about it, but we're excited to help our campers hear from other people around the world for whom the gospel has changed their lives, and they have this love to share the good news with us in the U.S. as well, and it's a tremendous thing. One of my great loves at camp, and a lot of people when they think about camp, they think about the outdoors, because we get to be in God's creation. And that's another one of our primary objectives, is for people to be in God's creation and recognize even creation speaks the great news of God. I love this. Psalm 19:1 starts out, "The heavens are telling the glory of God, and their expanse is declaring the work of his hands." In the New Testament, Jesus said, "Well, if you people don't praise me, the very rocks will cry out." We learn throughout the Old Testament, all of creation bears witness to God. And being in creation is such a great way to step aside and recognize we are not in control. God is. He really is. I invite you to do that some new way, maybe even this day. Pause. God's creation, recognize he's in control. Lastly, our last primary objective is to encourage and equip all believers to share their love for Jesus with others. Acts 1:8, you know, says, "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses both in Jerusalem and in Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth." That's in Lamar's, in Okoboji, and Sioux City, and across the globe. And we love to share that with campers too, that we are called to share the good news with others. And we try to practice in a few ways to share that good news, even in some of our camp weeks. I want to tell you about another quick story. Annie came to camp a few years ago now. Her friend invited her. Her friend first invited her to come to youth group, because Annie grew up in a family that wasn't involved in a church in any way. But she got invited, had fun at a couple of youth group events, and then her friend said, "Why don't you come to camp with me?" And so they came together to our music camp, and And there, not only did she get to learn more about music, but she learned more about God's great love for her. And she realized she really wanted and needed God in her life. And she had never really had a faith in Jesus. And so it began at camp that week. Praise the Lord. And then she went home, got more involved in the church, came back the next summer, and she said, I want to be baptized at camp. If that happens, and that does happen every once in a while, we love talking to campers and telling them, you know, we love that you want to be baptized at camp, but we also really love that a big part of baptism for so many is that it's shared with a community of faith, a local congregation. So that church can be a part of your continued growth and being nurtured and being together as followers of Christ. And so we shared that with her. And so she talked to that church. And we said, why don't you talk to your parents about this too? She talked to her parents. And they decided together, camp is a good place to do it. So the church had that blessing. And the parents actually not only said, yeah, that's good, they had a reawakening in their own lives because several years ago, before that, they had left the church and just decided to leave it all behind. And they realized, we're missing something. We want to come back to our God. And so now they are, as a family, trusting in the Lord, walking with God, and we praise God that someone shared and invited. And we have that privilege, friends, to share and invite, like Andrew, to say, come and see. And I invite you to do the same. Everywhere that you go, and whenever there seems like an opportunity, invite others to know Jesus, to walk with Jesus, and just to come along. It doesn't have to be complicated. I could talk a lot longer, but I'm not gonna. I want to say thanks again. So good to be with you. And I do want you invite you to come to camp as well. A couple specific additional invitations. We shared a brochure with you that talks about a bunch of things this summer. Hope you'll think about coming. If it's not helpful to you anymore, hope you'll think about passing it along to someone else, inviting them to come to camp. Family camp is a great way to come to camp. All week long, someone else does the cooking and cleaning. And you get to be refreshed, be on the lake. Let someone else help teach your kids. We're doing this as partnerships. Also, so there's 6 weeks of family camp, 17 different youth camp weeks. There's an elderversity camp. You have to be mature enough to go to that. And there are many other opportunities. Also, want to invite you to come. We're so thankful to your congregation and some specific people even within your congregation who have helped us to build a new beach house at Ingham Okoboji, at the Okoboji camp. We're going to dedicate that the day of our annual meeting, the last Saturday in April. You're invited. It'll be a joyous day. And then this is our 100th year. Next year we will celebrate our 100th anniversary. We believe we're the oldest Lutheran camp in the country. And thanks for being part of that. You were part of it long before I was. So thank you, and we invite you to be part of that celebration. It'll be the last weekend in June of 2024. And if you want to take a card and bring home with you to remind you of both of those things, there's one at our table. Hope you'll stop by and grab anything else that's helpful too. But more than anything else, you know what? Jesus loves you. There's life in Jesus, forgiveness, real life. And I hope you'll embrace him more and more as your Savior and Lord and friend, and help share that good news with others. Let's roll a video. That's just 2 minutes talking about camp. Greetings from Ingham Okoboji Lutheran Bible Camps. We are very thankful for your partnership in this ministry.
Camp is a chance for you to rest, to reconnect with family and friends, and to refocus your life on the Lord. We work hard to make camp a safe environment for you to grow in your faith and to have tremendous amounts of fun. When you come, you will experience programs rooted in Christ-centered staff, biblical teaching, genuine hope and healing, a playful and loving Christian community, and a vision of God's heart for the whole world. Our mission is to know Jesus Christ and to make Christ known to all, and it drives all we do.
Senior High Week is just really fun, good place to grow in your faith. Like, you have so many people that you can talk to, and there's so many different activities that just really helps you understand more about God.
Before I came, I wasn't that close to God. I think this experience has really changed that for me. It's changed a lot.
Other than church on Sunday, it's hard to find spiritual growth experiences that I can do with my whole family. But that's exactly what Family Camp at Okoboji is all about. And they do it in such a memorable and meaningful and easy to engage way.
Please consider how you can partner in this ministry and make an impact in your family, your community, and the world. Invite others to register for camp or apply to be a part of our 2023 summer staff. Support the ministry through your time or financial resources. And pray for the ministry of Ingham Okoboji Bible Camps.
Thanks again for your many ways that you support and partner with the camp. I think I missed saying thank you to the quilters. It's another group, and there's so many other groups within your church that are part of us in our work together. May God bless you, and may God continue to bless our work together.
Thank you, Rod. Appreciate you guys being here again. They'll be out in the narthex after church today, and so we hope you stop and talk to them. Let's rise up now and join our voices in song.
Resurrected to everlasting life.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us join our hearts in prayer. O Lord God, we pray your blessings upon the camp of Ingemokaboji Lutheran Bible Camps. Watch over their staff, their campers, and all who attend ministry there, O Lord. We thank you for our partnership. We ask that as you have blessed their first century, O Lord, that you will lead them into the next century, that all may praise your name and come to know your Son, Jesus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Especially we pray for our teachers and for our children in our midst. O Lord, let the light of Jesus shine brightly in their hearts and let them abide in you, bearing good fruit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, you send us out into the world to share your love with all people. Especially, Lord, we ask that by our words and in our actions, that you would comfort, encourage, and strengthen any of those who need a healing touch and an encouraging word. Especially today, we pray for Deanna, Stan, Chad, Diane, and Dylan. O Lord, pour out your mercy upon Clara, Brecca, Lily, Ron, and Christy. Remember your promises, God, for Amy, Steve, Denny, Morgan, and Will. And give every good thing for Matt and Tyler, Brian, Daryl, and Matt and Jolene, Jamie, Joe, and Jake. O Lord, we lift up to your care Tracy and all of those whom we name now in the quiet of our hearts. To these, your children, O Lord, we ask that you show all of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, give the promise of life everlasting to all who trust in you. Especially we pray your comfort for all the family of Dieter, that they would rejoice that he has come into your everlasting presence, and that they would be strengthened for their own earthly journey here. O Lord, until the day comes when you gather each of us, all of us together to our heavenly home, O Lord, guide us all the days of our lives with your Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, we pray for peace in our world, in our homes, in our schools, in our country. We pray for peace in Ukraine. We ask, O Lord, that you would watch over the innocent, that you would protect the Ukrainians. We ask, Lord, we pray fervently, that the Russians would have a new spirit and a right heart, that they would lay down their weapons and return to their own homes. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, our God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
I invite you to share Christ's peace with one another. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. God's blessings, brother. Peace be with you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts. Ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body that is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Then, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." And so, remembering our Lord, together let us pray as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now the table is set and all is prepared. Our Lord says, "Come and dine." And so regardless of whatever congregation you would ordinarily attend, you are welcome at the table. Please be seated, coming forward in two lines at the direction of your ushers. And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us through this gift, in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's join in our sending song. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.